Hello children, welcome to the math class. Today we will discuss about division of decimal number. So dear children, kindly open your book page number 113. Division by 10, 100, 1000, etc. If we divide this decimal number with 10, see the result, we get 21.23. Children, here you mark, if we divide 10, any number, then the decimal point is moved to left side by one place. Because here 10 is there. Then, next example you see, here also you observe. Here decimal place is here. Okay. If we divide this decimal number with 10, then we get 0.061. This decimal point is moved left side by one place. Okay. Then example 45. Here you see 536 divided 100. Here, if we divided this number with 100, then you see two places move left side. Because children, here two zeros are there. Okay, 5.36. Here you see three zeros are there. So, it move left side by three places. Okay. Then here we see some points are given. When we divide by 10, the decimal point shifts to the left by one place. When we divide by 100, the decimal point shifts to the left by two places. When we divide it by 1000, the decimal point shifts to the left by three places. Division is opposite of multiplication. Children, do you remember? Division is opposite of multiplication. So, multiplication by 10, 100 and 1000 increases the value of the number by 10, 100 and 1000 times. And division reduces the value by 10, 100 and 1000 times respectively. In multiplication, decimal point moves to the right and in division it moves to the left as many places as the zero is there are zeros in the division. For example, 80.15 divided 10. Here children, you mark one place moved by left side. Means 8.015. But when we multiply these two numbers, this decimal point is shifted to right side by one place. Means 801.5. Clear? Like this you see. Division of a decimal by a decimal number. Example 47. 0.24 divided 0.4. Here also two methods are there, long division method and by changing into fraction. In this method, what you do? Here we convert this number into whole number, which one is division. Okay. So we multiply 10. If we multiply 10, then this point, this decimal point is moved right side by one place. So the result will be 2.4 and this one is 4.0. Why it is necessary to convert this decimal point, decimal number to a whole number? Because children, when we divide, a division should be a whole number. We cannot divide a decimal number with another decimal number. Okay? So we must convert the divisor part to a whole number part. Now you see 2.4 divide 4. 4 zeros are 0, so 0. Then 2, 4, 6 are 24, 0.6. Here also it is written, remember in decimal division by long division method, the divisor must be changed to a whole number before you start dividing. Okay, then by changing into fraction, this is very easy. 0.24 means children 24 by 100 and 0.4 means 4 by 10. Then here division is there, so we multiply, and when we multiply we write the reciprocal of this fraction. So 10 by 4, here we reduce, then we get 6 by 10. 6 by 10 means 0.6. So children, like this two methods are there. Any methods you can use and find out the division. Then example 48. By long division method. Children, here you mark 7.2 and 0.12. This is the division. After decimal point, two places are there. So children, we have to multiply with 100. Then we can convert into a whole number. So 72 means 720 we can write instead of 7.2, and instead of 0.12 we can write 12. Then you divide, then you get 60, or 060 means 60. By changing into fraction, you convert into decimal fraction, then you reduce, then you get your answer. Like this children, you see yourself example 49. Then comes to exercise 7.6. One number divide. You follow the example and do the division. Two number divide by long division method. Here children, only you apply here long division method. But here any one method, whatever you think easy, that method you can apply and find out the division. Okay, then comes to three number divide by changing the decimal number into decimal fraction and express the quotient as the decimal number. Here children, you apply the second method by changing into fraction. Okay, after that you have to change the result into a decimal number. So up to three number, your homework, you complete exercise 7.6 in your copy. Thank you.